The next Timeline Effects tool we will look at is Text for 2D title creation. In the sequence, we need to create an animated title that says Zone 1. When it comes to titling, I normally use gap effects above the edit. We can adjust the length of the title as well as apply fade in and fade out. You can start off by selecting the segment you want the title to go over. Move the focus point to the next video track. If you don't have another video track, simply click on the Track Plus button to create a new one. Pressing the keyboard shortcut Shift-V will cut the gap segment to the length of the selection. Let's right-click on the gap segment and select Add Effect. In the Effects ribbon, click on Text, and the text timeline effects will be applied to the gap segment. To create and edit text, you must go into the text editor. Let's quickly fit the image to the view by clicking the Zoom pull-down menu and choosing Fit. Now, to create any text, you must first create a new layer. You can either click the New Layer button or just tap on the view. In the text layer, you can type your text, Zone 1. So regarding the overall function of text and creating titles, the text tool uses layers like Photoshop. You can have as many text layers as you want, but for now, we'll keep it simple. Now, the text tool has multiple modes to handle text layers. You can look at these modes in the Text Mode pull-down menu. The two main modes are Move and Edit. You can toggle between Move and Edit by pressing the Escape keyboard shortcut. When you want to move the text layer, either dragging on screen or slider-based controls, you need to be in Move mode. But when you create your text or edit your text, you do it in Edit mode. Now let's look at the text tools in detail. The text editor is divided up into four sections. Starting on the left, you have all the color attributes such as text color, outline, and shadow. The next section deals with the font and paragraph options. The third section is the character channels and text path tools. These three sections will always be displayed in the interface. The fourth section is switchable, but the default menu is Axis. Axis refers to an object's position within the image. But in terms of transformations, you can apply positioning to the entire text layer or individual characters. Everything you do is selection-based. You need to first select the layer or characters before applying the change. So to change any properties of the text, you need to be in Edit mode. Next, you need to select the characters to be adjusted. To select all the characters in the layer, press Option A. Just enable the Fill, Outline, and Shadow tools to apply the changes to the text. You can also adjust parameters such as font size, kerning, paragraph alignment, and more. Let's quickly center the text. Change the paragraph alignment to center. Next, we can center the layer in the middle of the screen. Under the Axis heading, change the axis center point from top left to center. Set both X and Y position to 0. There are actually a few ways to center the text layer, but this is pretty quick. To change the font, click on the Font Names box. This will open Smoke's file browser. If you only see font titles, switch to the font thumbnails by clicking on the button at the top left of the screen. If your thumbnails appear to be grey, simply click on the Generate Proxy button and Smoke will create the font previews for you. Smoke supports a variety of different fonts. You can choose the font type in the pull-down menu, but I'll choose Auto to show all the files in the current folder. When Smoke is installed, it installs some default fonts, but you can access your system fonts by clicking on the System Fonts folder. One useful point worth remembering is that Smoke does not require you to install the font in the macOS Fonts folder, so you don't have to have thousands of fonts installed just to access them. Simply select the font you want and press the Load button to return back to the text editor. Now let's do a quick animation to add a bit of movement to this title. Ensure that you press Escape to return back to Move mode. Turn on Auto Key. You might know this better as Auto Keyframe. Go to the beginning of the segment and position the text to the right of the screen. Go to the last frame and position the text to the left of the screen. Turn Auto Key off. When you scrub the time bar, you can see the horizontal movement you have created. We'll be covering more animation in a later video. Press Return to go back to the sequence. To conclude this video, navigate the positioner to the beginning of the gap effect by pressing the up arrow keyboard shortcut. Press Shift Command A to deselect everything. Click on the Transition button and add a dissolve to the beginning of the gap effect to fade the title in. You can also add a dissolve by pressing Command T. You can drag the duration of the slider to increase the length of the fade in. The same can be done at the end of the gap segment. Press the down arrow keyboard shortcut to move to the end of the gap segment. Press Command T to fade the title out. Once again, drag the duration slider to increase the length of the fade out. You can scrub or play the title to preview it. To render the result, hold down Command and select the gap effect and the two dissolves. Press the render button or press backslash to start the render. Once Smoke has processed the selection, you'll be able to play the final result. Please move on to the next video to continue your Smoke Getting Started experience.